You would like to know whether the given series, which is a quite complicated one, k plus 1 over k squared plus 2k plus 3, is convergent or divergent. So two methods. Either you can use the integral test, and by the integral I mean replacing the k with x, and I can see the u substitution working here. If you let u being the denominator, the numerator will be 2x plus 2, right? So basically you can multiply 2 over 2 to the fraction here and then work it out. But that's a little bit more complicated. I would use the second method, which is the limit comparison test. Okay, so limit comparison test. And the limit comparison test basically compares two sequences, A subscript k and B subscript k, which are both greater than 0. Okay, so basically what it says is that you're going to take the limit as k approaches infinity of the quotient. Okay, and the quotient will be a subscript k, the first sequence, divided by the b subscript k. So the a subscript k will be the primary sequence, right? The primary given fraction. And the b subscript k is going to be something that you determine. Okay, and that will be the limit value, which will be greater than 0. So if that's true, then either ak, well, I should say the series now, not the sequence, the sequence of partial sums, okay, so the series a subscript k and the second series b subscript k both diverge or converge, or both converge. Okay, so they will be interdependent, right? So either both converge or both diverge, but provided that the limit value of the quotient of these two sequences of the terms here, as you take the k to infinity, will be the limit value that is greater than 0. Only then you can base either divergence of both or convergence of both. So let's try to use this one here. So first we have to understand that the a subscript k is going to be k plus 1 divided by k squared plus 2k plus 3. So now the bk will be the related sequence, okay, the b subscript k. So notice that as k gets larger and larger, the dominating terms in the numerator and denominator will be k and k squared, right? So you're talking about k divided by the k squared as being the dominating parts in the numerator and the denominator. So in other words, as k gets larger and larger and larger, this fraction will start to, the terms here represented by the fraction will start to look more like this, k divided by the k squared. So in other words, 1, 2k plus 3, they will not affect the value of the general term, the a subscript k term, for a certain value of k. It will be really close to the b subscript k term as k gets large, right? So these two will be approximately, they will be closer and closer to each other. So always look at the dominating terms in the numerator and denominator. So in this case, it's k over k squared, which is going to be 1 over k if you simplify this. So now let's find the quotient now that we found the b subscript k sequence. We can use the quotient now. So we're going to take the limit as k approaches infinity of a subscript k divided by the b subscript k. So that's going to be equal to k plus 1 over k squared plus 2k plus 3. Okay, and it will be divided by the b subscript k, right? So so how are we going to do that? We're going to do divided by 1 over k. Okay, so then what are we going to have? We're going to have k plus 1 over k squared plus 2k plus 3 times k. Okay, so then we're going to have, well, I forgot the limit sign. Okay, let me put the limit sign in there. Okay, the limit sign. So here we're going to have the limit sign again. So let's see what happens. We get k squared plus k divided by k squared plus 2k plus 3. So as you can see, this is a standard limit problem now. I'm going to divide by 1 over k squared. Okay, so basically what I'm trying to do, I'm trying to find the value, the finite value L that is greater than 0. Because if we do that, then we can base our answers on the limit value, on whether one of them is, whether both are divergent or convergent, right? So first we have to find the limit value to make sure that we get a positive limit value, okay? We're testing, in other words, this part. No. This is what we're testing. We're testing this part here to make sure that the limit value is greater than 0. Okay, so we're going to divide now both the numerator and denominator by the k with the highest power, which is k squared. So k squared plus 2k plus 3 divided by k squared. So then we're going to have 1 plus 1 over k divided by 1 plus 2 over k plus 3 over k squared. So as you can see now, we can plug in the infinity part now. So we're going to have 1 plus 0, because 1 over infinity is 0, over 1 plus 0 plus 0, right? So that's equal to 1. So notice that 1 is greater than 0. So we actually satisfy the condition that the finite value, limit value, is 1, which is greater than 0. So that means that we can actually compare now, because if one of these guys is divergent, then the other one will be divergent as well. So we picked the sequence really close to the original sequence, which is 1 over k, right? So notice that 1 over k, notice that this 1 over k is divergent, right? It's a harmonic series. And you can also test that this theory by recognizing that this is the p series, right? Where p is equal to 1. So as you know, if p is less than or equal to 1, right, the power of k here is the p value, right? You know that's for sure it's a divergent. So two ways to test. Either you do the harmonic series testing, but the harmonic series you have to compare it with the integral and it takes more time. So if you just recognize that this is a p series where p is equal to 1 and it's a divergent series because p is less than or equal to 1, which is in this case it's satisfied, then this is divergent. Now since this is divergent and we already used the limit comparison test, then the original one must be divergent, right? Because they depend on each other. Both diverge or both converge, right? Either that or the other. So that's going to be leading to divergent, the original series, okay? So thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video.